So good afternoon to all, hope you are doing great. So in this video, we'll be discussing about top 2 stocks that we can buy right now and we can either hold them for short term and carry forward them to long term as well. So first, we'll discuss what are the 2 stocks and then we'll try to do the complete technical analysis and we'll see what can be the best entry in these 2 stocks. So make sure you're watching the video till the end. And if you're new to the channel, then definitely subscribe the channel and also press the bell icon to get instantly notified. And most importantly, do join the Telegram group because in Telegram, we'll discuss all the instant updates followed by stocks for intraday, short term, followed by long term as well. I'll provide a link in the description followed by comment section. Okay. So the first stock that we're going to discuss today is going to be HCL Technologies, so well-known IT company. So we know recently Accenture has declared a very good quarter result in the US markets and obviously it would create a positive sentiment for all the IT companies. And technically HCL Technologies is looking at a very good levels. So we'll see once we go to the technical charts. So we'll also try to see the basic fundamentals of HCL Tech. So basically it has a very good presence in global markets, whether it may be America, Europe, India, followed by rest of the world. Percentage wise, we can see maximum business, the revenue is coming from US markets, which is somewhere around 58%. So recently we also seen that the dollar index suddenly started going in the upside direction. So earlier, so it was somewhere around 74. So now it is somewhere around 76. So a good growth in dollar index signifies that IT companies will start showing a very good rally, followed by a very good quarter result of Accenture creates a positive impact in our markets as well. But we know only the IT stocks are holding the Nifty, but whereas other sectors are significantly correcting, especially banks and various other sectors because of FIIs selling. So it is a right time to add some very good quality stocks into your DMAT. So one such stock today we are discussing is HCL Technologies. So main verticals for this particular company is financial services, followed by manufacturing and technology services, which constitute for major portion of the business. Okay, so moving towards market cap, it is obviously known that it is a large cap company with more than 3 lakh crore as a market cap. Current price is somewhere around 1171, high and low is around somewhere 1300 and low is only around 850. Stock P is somewhere around 27.6 and book value of 224. Dividend is also given by the company on a regular basis, which is somewhere around 1.88%. Return on capital employed, which is very important. So the company is providing somewhere around 25.7% as return on capital employed. And last one, return on equity is somewhere around 19.8%. So moving towards pros and cons. So the company has reduced the debt and it's almost debt free and it is maintaining a healthy dividend payout. As we have seen, very good percentage is also there. And if we try to have a peer comparison in the markets, obviously TCS is the market leader when we talk about IT sector. So there we can see TCS offers somewhere around 48.90 as return on capital employed. But whereas HCL Tech is also giving a very good competition in the market with almost 25.70 as ROCE. Okay, so next, moving towards the financial section. So first let us talk about operating profit. So you can see operating profit somewhere around 5022. So a steady increment is present on quarter on quarter basis. That is well and good. And profit before tax was somewhere around 4101 crores. So there also we are seeing a very good steady increment. Net profit is around somewhere 3259. So there also we are seeing a steady growth. So nothing to worry about this particular company because already it's a large cap company. So we can't expect multi-bagger returns, but we can expect a safe and decent return, especially in this market situation where little bit of panic selling is happening in the market. Alright, so quickly let's go to technical charts and we'll try to see what are the best levels that I have observed, and you can also watch them. Okay, so now we are back on to the technical charts of HCL Tech, and you can see clearly this is the weekly chart that I've opened. So previous close, it has given 1% positive movement despite the market fall. As I told, IT stocks are looking very bullish at the current market situation, and once you observe the chart, you can see the stock is forming a very good pattern of inverted head and shoulder pattern. So that is little complicated to draw, but if I take it to daily chart, so clearly you can identify a inverted head and shoulder pattern. So what would be the target? So target would be somewhere from the neckline to the head. Okay, so from the neckline to the head, if you project that in upside direction, so that would be your targets. Okay, so where is the neckline coming? So neckline is coming somewhere around the 1200. So for positive or safe entry, so better once it closes above that 1200 rupees level, you can expect a very good targets in the upside direction. Maybe it may cross 1300 and 1400 rupees level also in the midterm. So this chart pattern is very successful pattern, and many people recommend that as well. So if we do the back testing of this particular chart pattern earlier also, it has given a very good move, same inverted head and shoulder pattern. After giving breakout, we have seen a very good rally in the upside direction. Okay, so keep this particular stock in radar. So it is looking very good, especially IT stocks are looking bullish. So HCL Tech is going to be a very good pick in the current market situation. Okay, so next, moving further toward the second stock that we'll be discussing today is going to be Minda Corporation. So well known automotive component manufacturing company. So we already know it has a very good presence in the 2 to 3 wheeler segment, followed by commercial vehicles and passenger vehicles, and basically major portion, you know, it's in India itself, 86% manufacturing and all, and rest it's basically in Europe and American markets, followed by East Asian market. So this is also a very good company, but it's improving. So if you see the market cap, it is somewhere around 3,923 crores. Current price is somewhere around 164. So not a highly valued company. It's present at a very decent valuations. High and low, you can see high is somewhere around 180. Low is only 77.2. Stock P is around 36.1. Book value of 49. And dividend yield is around 0.40%, ROCE is around 7.51, and return on equity is around 4.97%. As I told, it is improving, but it's a very good stock for long term. All right, so coming to pros, it is expected to give a very good quarter result, and sales and dividend payout is one negative thing. But as I told, all the companies which perform well, it's not mandatory that they need to give the dividend. So people who focus majorly on business, so they don't basically focus on that dividend part. Okay, so if we try to have a peer comparison, so we can see ROC percentage wise, we can see it is around 7.51, and major companies like Endurance Tech give us around 16.67. Okay, so next, if we see the financials and if we see revenue, very good increment was present in year-on-year basis as we compare with the past result. So 11.45% increment was there. Net income has grown almost by 50%. EPS increased by 42.98. Net profit margin also by 35.53%. So if we see the overall stock performance after it got listed, so we can see the 2018 level somewhere around 200 was acting as a major resistance for the stock, and afterwards it has never approached that particular zone. Okay, but in the recent times, whatever the rally we have seen in the stock, it is almost trying to approach that 200 mark. So if it breaks that 200 in near term, then definitely we can see 300 plus very soon in this particular stock. So technically also, as I told, it is forming a very good pattern. So let's quickly go to weekly chart and daily chart. Okay, so now we are back on to the monthly chart of Minda Corp, and same as I told, you can see a very good pattern here as well, and it has given a very good breakout. Okay, so breakout has been completed, so now it is coming for a perfect retest. Also retest, I think also that's also been successfully completed, but now only thing is little bit of upside momentum should be observed in it. So as I told, it's a very good stock for midterm to long term, so keep holding it. Target would be somewhere from this particular neckline to the bottom. So if you project that, somewhere around 300 plus can be easily observed in it. So patience is required. Keep holding it. Find some best quality stocks for long term in this market situation. So these two stocks are looking very good. So each and every dip, you can accumulate these two companies for midterm to long term. Okay. So any further queries, you can also ask in the comment section, and also you can connect with me in Instagram. Instagram ID is stocksdairyyt. Until then, stay safe. Take care. Bye-bye.